we begin with the U.S. congressional campaign against the Duterte administration. California Congresswoman Jackie Spears has introduced a resolution condemning the continued detention of Philippine Senator Leila de Lima, who was arrested over 2 years ago on allegations related to drug trafficking. In a letter urging her colleagues to co-sponsor the House Resolution 233, Spears said the charges against Senator de Lima have been widely repudiated by human rights groups, non-governmental organizations, parliamentary bodies, and others as retaliation for her continued criticism of extrajudicial killings and the Duterte regime's anti-drug campaign. De Lima was arrested on drug-related charges for allegedly using her capacity as Secretary of Justice to take money from the already imprisoned drug pushers to allow them to still do business. The evidence in her non-bailable arrest consisted of testimony of prison inmates, police officers, and former prison officials. H.R. 233, which already has five co-sponsors, not only demands the immediate release of de Lima and for all charges against her be dropped, it also condemns what Spears calls state-sanctioned extrajudicial killings in the Philippines, as well as the arrest and detention of human rights defenders. The main proponents of H.R. 233 include Amnesty International, Filipino-American Human Rights Alliance, Ecumenical Advocacy Network on the Philippines, International Coalition for Human Rights in the Philippines, and United Church of Christ San Mateo. And joining us now here in the studio is Ago Pedalizo, the San Francisco coordinator of the Filipino-American Human Rights Alliance, or FARA, to talk more about the community efforts to get House Resolution 233 introduced. Thank you for joining us here on BA, Ago.
Thank you, Jel.
Now, will you tell us the story behind this drafting of the resolution, how you communicated with Congresswoman Jackie Spears?
It's been 2 years in the making. The first time kami nag-usap, mga 3 minutes lang. Pero I was very open with her. We need you to support us. We need you to speak in our behalf. Kaya tingnan mo naman, the next day, she was the only one who spoke at the Tom Lantos Human Rights Commission. Wala nang iba. Then after that, nagkaroon ng tatlong forum dito. Dumating sila Senator Trillanes, Aliano, Father Bert, lahat yon. Ang sinasabi ko lang, when we did the negotiations, there should be at least 500 people on the table. And then maraming negotiations. You have the Methodist Church, United Church of Christ, Presbyterian, pati mga human rights group. The point is, the response we're getting from Jackie Spear is proportionate to the amount of education and sincerity that we afford the office.
And what was her initial reaction?
Well, definitely she was sympathetic to the victims in complete solidarity. But of course, for any politicians, they're kind of hesitant to move.
All right.
It takes so much effort.
So this is a big move then for her to be able to do this.
Exactly. The second meeting we had was 30 minutes.
I'm sure a lot of our Kababayans are asking, okay, this resolution would condemn the action, extrajudicial killing, and the continued imprisonment of Leila de Lima. But would there be sanctions?
Well, definitely.
I mentioned earlier. Tell us more about
this. Kung dito naman congressional process, ang resolution, that's the first step. Magkaroon ka ng resolution, magkaroon ka ng sense of Congress, pagkatapos ng committee hearing, pagkatapos ng congressional bill. Yung bill na pinopropose namin, and we're the one crafting the language na ina-approve naman nila. Very definite ron, we want to cut the supply of arms to the Philippine National Police, who are definitely the number one violator of human rights. Gusto rin namin yung pera would be geared more on having the yung drugs as a public safety issue, tapos yung even yung mga surveillance, the mga narcotics, and at the very end gusto namin yung relationship ng Philippines and US shall be anchored on human rights. So hindi ibig sabihin business as usual tayo. Kailangan may talagang it should be anchored on human rights as a matter of foreign policy.
Were you able to communicate with Senator Leila de Lima?
Yes.
Especially after this resolution has been
during the whole process, nakikipag-usap kami sa kanya through the staff and through some emissaries. Very in high spirit, very supportive. Of course, under stress siya. Pero the point is, so long as yung solidarity from the grassroots and definitely from the OFWs from the U.S. are there, she will be there. She actually represents the whole opposition. Okay. Definitely, maraming pang political prisoners, mga 400 yan. Maraming pang victims. But definitely, right now, to have de Lima release is a big move for us.
All right. At yan ang aabangan ng ating mga kababayan, whether or not they are for or against this move of your group and the community effort.
Yes, in the coming months, may na-form na mga lobby groups, and we definitely, you know, invite the Filipino people
Thank
to be
you.
Part of
Thank
this
Thank you
move.
Very much. Thank
Salamat
you, Ago.
Din.
Mabuhay
Thank you, Jill.
Thank you.